Hello students. So in this lecture, I'm going to start a new chapter which is called interference. So in this lecture, I will discuss about the interference. So let's start this lecture. So what is interference? Interference is when two waves are superimposed. The resultant wave is formed by algebraic sum of these two waves. When two or more waves are superimposed, the resultant wave may be a dark or a bright, means intensity of a light may be increased or decreased. Maybe a completely dark or very bright spot can be formed. How it is formed, that phenomenon is called interference. Now, what I mean is, suppose this is one wave, this is the input one wave. When this is superimposed on another wave, suppose which is also is in same phase, because phase consideration is must when we are doing the superimposition. So this is the one wave, this is second wave. When they will superimpose, what will they maxima will overcome with maxima, then zero is zero. When they will interference, means they will superimpose, they will form a resultant waveform which will be of very high intensity, means amplitude of resultant waveform will be very high, but we will say a dark light will be formed. This amplitude is, if this is V1, this is V2, the amplitude will be V1 plus V2. So this is phenomena is called constructive interference. So this is nothing but constructive interference. Now, what is the condition? Suppose this is waveform 1, this is waveform 2. What we will need? Superimposition of these two waves. Now, if we want to if we shift this waveform to the right or to the left by an amount of pi or 2 pi, suppose this is the time period t, this is the same time period t. Now, if we shift the wavelength of this waveform is lambda, if we shift the wavelength by lambda, we will get the same waveform. Now, that is called constructive interference. Now, for condition for constructive interference is when maxima will overcome with maxima and the least, that is called this point will superimpose with this. So that is the means wavelength, the power phase difference between these two waveforms is lambda. Then always, if we shift the waveform by lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda, we will get the same condition. Now, so this is the condition for constructive interference. This is the resultant or the superimposed waveform of these two inputs. Now, these two waveforms are superimposed to form this resultant waveform, which is of very high intensity or the very high amplitude. Now, this is due to constructive interference. Now, to get this very high amplitude waveform, what we did, we find the condition that the power difference between these two must be, that is the lambda. If we shift the waveform by lambda to lambda, we will get the same condition. So to get this type of waveform, that is called constructive interference, the power difference should be n lambda, means n can be 1, 2, 3, plus minus. So n can be plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, and so on. If we shift the waveform completely, now instead of getting this very high amplitude waveform, we can get a very low waveform as well. Like if we superimpose these two waveforms, suppose this is the input waveform 1. Now, if we superimpose this waveform, if we shift this waveform by lambda by 2, so this waveform will start by from at this point. Now, because waveform is existing from minus infinity to plus infinity, instead of starting this, the power difference between these two is, the phase difference between these two is lambda by 2. So if there is a power difference or the phase difference of lambda by 2, see the power difference, because phase difference is how much? 180 degree. There we have phase difference of 360 degree. Now if the power difference is lambda by 2, where lambda is the wavelength, right? If between these two power differences lambda by 2, what we get? We will get a dark fringe, because when we will superimpose these two waveforms. The resultant waveform will be, this is maximum, this is minimum. So when we will add, suppose this is 5, let's take an example, this is minus 5. So when we will add this plus 5, minus 5, but we will get 0. So the resultant waveform will be 0. Means a waveform, this was the waveform present, but the resultant waveform is completely dark. So we say that brightness is increased in case of constructive interference. This type of interference is called destructive interference. That is called destructive interference. Now, in case 2, 4, constructive interference, the condition is that, see, what is the power difference? Power difference must be power difference is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. Means if we shift the waveform by odd multiples of lambda, means not we can put n equal to 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2. Means we shift the waveform by lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2. If we put n equal to 0, what is the power difference? That is lambda by 2. If we put n equal to 1, what we get? That is 1, 3, 3 by 2 lambda. Like similarly, so for constructive interference, this is the condition for destructive interference. So this is nothing but destructive interference, and this is the condition, means power difference for destructive interference. This is the constructive interference. So in case of constructive interference, the brightness will increase. In case of destructive interference, brightness will decrease completely. This is called dark fringes observed, and this is called a bright fringe will be observed. So next we will discuss about interferometer.